Will all guests please rise for the class of 2019? Good evening, ladies, gentlemen, and to the class of 2019. Could you please join me and stand and face the flag to the Pledge of Allegiance? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may now be seated.
graduate has asked that you treat this exercise with the utmost respect. Every graduate deserves to hear her name announced. Please refrain from using any noisemakers, horns, bells, yells, or any other distractions that are not conducive to maintaining the dignity and grandeur of this event. We ask that you hold your applause and congratulatory yells until after all names have been called, so that the next name can be clearly heard. Your assistance will help provide the best graduation for each student. Thank you in advance for your cooperation to ensure a dignified graduation ceremony.
Los alumnos graduados han pedido que trate este evento con mucho respeto. Cada graduado obedece oír su nombre anunciado. Por favor, absténgase de usar maracas, bocinas, campanas, gritos o cualquier otro distractor que no sea apropiado para el mandamiento y la dignidad y grandeza de este evento. Les pedimos de manera mantener sus aplausos y gritos de felicitación hasta que todos los nombres hayan sido llamados para que el nombre de la próxima persona llamada pueda ser escuchado claramente. Su cooperación ayudará a proporcionar la mejor graduación para cada estudiante. Gracias de antemano por su cooperación para asegurar una digna ceremonia de graduación. Gracias.
Welcome to our distinguished guests, faculty, staff, students, parents, grandparents, guardians, visitors, and friends. We are here today to witness the commencement ceremony for the class of 2019. The 61 young women seated before us have accomplished a significant milestone in their lives. It is an honor and privilege to stand here today to honor them, to recognize their achievements, to celebrate their journey thus far, and to remind them once again about how much we believe in them. If you give a girl a plaid skirt, she will honor her narrative, find her voice, dream big, forge her path to college, and help others across the opportunity gap. If you give a girl a plaid skirt, her life changes. And then she changes the lives of those around her, starting with her family, community, nation, and world. As bright, ambitious Rengalians, you wore your plaid skirt proudly for the past several years, as we recognize your potential and watched you grow to become the world changers you are today. Today, you will graduate and influence others to believe in the beauty of their dreams, to believe that hard work and resilience are the pathways to success, and to believe in themselves as you believed in yourself and each other. You have so much to offer the world. Go forth and take your place. This world needs you. It needs your kindness, your grace, your humility, and your consideration and thoughtfulness for others. Use that, along with your other amazing skills, to make humanity that much better. I'll close by reminding you again that today, the honor is ours, the future is yours. We hand it to you with confidence and pride. Girls today, women tomorrow, leaders forever.
First of all, I would like to thank all of you, friends, family, staff, for being in attendance today. You've all made a significant impact in our lives, whether by inspiring us with wisdom, acting like the best cheerleaders throughout our journey, entertaining us with random off-topic stories, offering a helping hand during hard times. We wouldn't have made it here without you. When I arrived to the United States as a little clueless 6-year-old girl, I could have never imagined the journey set ahead of me and the kind of family I would run into along the way. If you had told me 7 years ago that one day I'd be standing here making this speech, I wouldn't have believed it. It wasn't just the fact that I was failing two of my classes or that I just didn't care about anything, but also the fact that I didn't think I'd make it this far. However, as the years went on, things changed. I'm not sure when it happened, whether it was gradual or sudden, but it happened. I found myself amongst friends, or what I like to call sisters by heart. Girls who made me cry with laughter, smile with joy, and feel genuinely loved. I'm not just addressing my close friends, but also my classmates. Some of my favorite moments during my time at Brunel involved connecting with peers who I didn't think I had much in common with. Those small moments when we complained about school assignments, laughed about random internet memes, ranted about difficult tests, talked about our favorite hobbies, bonded during an unexpected sisterhood circle in the beds of a cabin, or addressed our future plans, always managed to leave me smiling. And soon enough, I found myself realizing that this place is my second home. And that this was a family. I've struggled with emotional issues since I've arrived to this country. And for a long time, I didn't believe I could make it take. Even during my transition to high school, I was doubtful of my ability to overcome myself. But it seemed like everyone here believed otherwise. During my lowest moments, my sisters came through. Whether by organizing a surprise birthday party for me, letting me express everything going on in my life on the benches of a park, serenading me with Baby by Justin Bieber, tickling me till my stomach hurts, or offering a shoulder to cry on. They came through, and they saved my life. I can't imagine a lifetime without the school, and I don't really want to. This place was life-changing, and it's impossible for me to forget it. I've built countless beautiful memories here. I've gained valuable advice from mentors and teachers. I've formed wonderful friendships. I've opened up my heart and soul to you all by making this speech. To the class of 2019, I want to thank you all with all of my heart for being the sisters I never got to have. I hope the best for each and every one of you. I want to let you know that you are all special, gifted, capable, and beautiful. I know you will accomplish great things in life. And no matter the obstacles in front of you, I know you will rise above them. I hope you embark on this journey with confidence. I hope you make the best out of bad circumstances, because those will never go away. I hope you make lots of mistakes along the way that help you grow and better yourselves. I hope you develop more of the types of friendships Renho gifted us with. I hope you continue to shine amidst the darkness. I hope you remember the only person capable of creating a significant change in your life is yourself. I hope you continue to live your life smiling, laughing, and hoping for the best tomorrow. Thank you.
Good evening, parents, teachers, friends, family, distinguished guests, and most importantly, my fellow classmates. Today I am honored and extremely humbled to be speaking on behalf of the class of 2019, the 11th graduating class of Irma Lerma Ranhel Young Women's Leadership School, the first public all-girls school in the state of Texas. Today, exactly 2,643 days ago, many of us received a letter. Some of you, it came later. But for each of us, it was a letter that changed the course of our lives forever. The letter read as follows. Thank you for submitting an application to attend Irma Lerma Ranhel Young Women's Leadership School. A careful review of your application has resulted in a rating of accepted. And as you held the letter in your small hands, you felt your heart racing, and you probably had more than a few doubts coming to Ranhel, because seriously, being surrounded by girls 24/7 is hard work. Nevertheless, you took a leap of faith and decided to join the Sisterhood of the Plaid. On August 27th, 2012, those same hands that opened the acceptance letter now opened the heavy front door. We walked around wide-eyed and curious to explore the huge building we would call home for the next 7 years. We wore those red cardigans that constantly itched and scratched at us, but made us look adorable in the eyes of our parents. We attempted to find our niche, mingling between groups, until we finally found people who shared our same kind of weirdness. We reminded ourselves to put our name at the bottom of the paper in Miss Williams' room. We failed to win middle school wars 3 years in a row, even though one of those years, it was rigged in our favor. We tried not to cry when we failed our first tests, quizzes, projects, homeworks, you name it, we failed it. And when we realized we were no longer the brightest student in the room, not because we had suddenly lost all our brightness, but because finally we had arrived at a place where teachers like Ms. Clark and administrators like Ms. Zamudio held us to higher standards. And we all shined brighter together. And slowly we began to wipe our tears away with the same hands that held the letter and opened the door. And then the next chapter began, high school. By the time high school rolled around, we each had found something new to create with our hands, whether it be as founding members of the robotics team, activists, actors, social media gurus, published writers, or documentarians. Every day brought us closer as we realized just how much we needed each other to survive. We depended on each other to get us through our lowest points. There were rejections from colleges, to scholarships, to even relationships, and the moments we felt like all hope was lost and we didn't believe we could make it. But we also depended on each other to celebrate the highest points, winning the Powerpuff game, meeting Michelle Obama, putting on a legendary prom, shout out to the prom committee, receiving the news that we ranked the 6th best high school in Texas, the highest ranking our school has ever received. And although at times graduation felt like it would never come, it did. Here we are, ready to move on. All of our hard work, tears, restless nights paid off because this year we were admitted to 116 different colleges in 26 different states, including DC and 3 different countries outside the US, including Spain, France, and South Korea. Those same hands that held the letter, opened the door, wiped away the tears, and created change now clicked submit and committed to the college of our choice. However, these accomplishments wouldn't have been possible without the support of many individuals that worked behind the scenes to get us through this whole year. Thank you, Ms. Moreno, Ms. Rohde, Ms. Hamilton, Mr. Strau, Ms. Wu, Senora Martinez, Mr. Wright, Mr. Ariza, and anyone else I'm missing out for guiding our nervous hands to apply to schools we didn't know we would love, scholarships we didn't think we would receive, and grants we didn't think we qualified for. I would also like to thank our class sponsors, Ms. Smith, Ms. Wu, and Ms. Tatum, for making this year more amazing and wonderful than we could have ever hoped for. A special thanks to Ms. Smith. You saw us grow from undisciplined and wild 9th graders to a little more civilized 12th graders, and still love us every step of the way. Thank you, Ms. Rohde, for both baking us delicious cupcakes, muffins, I mean, and for inspiring us to think outside the box. Thank you, Senora Martinez, for planning an amazing senior banquet where many tears were shed as we remember the past 7 years at Edwin Hill with our families. Gracias, mamá y papá, por todo el cariño y amor que me dieron. Gracias por trabajar demasiado, sufriendo horas agotadoras en un país que no siempre fue muy amable. Si no se hubieran atrevido a soñar con una vida mejor para mis hermanos y para mí, no habría estado aquí. Los amo. I would also like to thank the Lord for giving me the best brothers in the whole world. Thank you, Dani, for sharing your love of YouTube videos with me, even though you never really asked for me to join. I will never forget the many GMM videos we watched together. Thank you, Paquito. I would not be the same person I am today if I hadn't had you in my life. I will never forget the countless times you took me and Dani to bike around White Rock Lake, and when you told me I was more than just another brick in the wall. Lastly, thank you, ladies, for all the wonderful, hilarious memories you gave me. We aren't connected by blood, but we are connected by our hands. All of our hands held the letter, opened the door, wiped away tears, created something new, clicked submit, and were guided by those who love us. Now, ladies, I want you to take the hands of your sisters and hold close the memories we have made, open the doors of success, wipe away others' tears, click submit to those incredible job offers, and those assignments you will continue to procrastinate on. Create new opportunities and guide yourself through your own journey. And as Ms. Smith would say, buena chance, buena suerte, buena fortuna, cambate, choc memo, lahayim, goodbye, and good luck, y'all, on the rest of your life.
As principal of Irma Lermarin Howe Young Women's Leadership School, I hereby affirm that each candidate has met all requirements for graduation as determined by the State of Texas and the Dallas Independent School District, and they are qualified to receive their diplomas, or they are otherwise qualified to participate in this graduation ceremony consistent with the laws of the State of Texas and the Dallas Independent School District.
Chief Financial Officer of Dallas Independent School District, I am pleased to confirm the certification of the 2019 graduating class of Irma Lermarin Howe Young Women's Leadership School.
Diana Veronica de la Paz, highest honors. Veronica Ledesma, Monsivais, highest honors. Jacqueline Hernandez, highest honors. Michaela Kleiner, highest honors. Natalie Chavez, high honors. Juliana Hernandez, high honors. Rosilda Amezquita, honors. Bianca Kiambao Bacani, high honors. Ashanti Desiree Simone. Jennifer Carreño Toscano, high honors. Katie Kasaka, high honors. Serena Lachey Cowens, honors. Nayeli Michelle De Leon, high honors. Valeria De La Cruz, high honors. Daisy Devora, honors. Alyssa Monique Diaz, high honors. Ashley Equinugo, high honors. Yeah. Mirka Estrada, high honor. Leslie Flores Gutierrez, high honors. Elizabeth Flores, high honors. Guadalupe Gamiz, high honors. Maricela Garza. Vanessa Guell Guerrero, high honors. Genesis Guerra, high honors. Ana Cristina Hernandez, high honors. Kelsey Johnson, high honors. Judith Juarez, high honors. Isabel Ray Kirby, high honors. Sidali Lopez. Alexandra Luna Garcia, high honors. Joanna Marquez Espinosa, high honors. Guadalupe Victoria Martinez Carrillo, high honors. April Montserrat Medina, high honors. Aridai Mendez, high honors. Alexandra Mendoza, high honors. Lydia Margaret Mendoza, honors. Denise Monreal, high honors. Jessica New, high honors. Jerusalem Olivares, high honors. Mildred Olivares Garcia, honors. Marlene Pacheco, high honors. Daniela Portillo, honors. Vanessa Portugal, high honors. Angie Ramos, high honors. Annika Marley Richter, high honors. Tahani Rivera, honors. America Rodriguez, high honors. Cristal Rodriguez, high honors. Kaylee Rojas, high honors. Paula Ermelinda Rojas, high honors. Alma Romero Hernandez, honors. Giselle Sanchez Roma, high honors. T. Shi, high honors. Tapia. Marilyn Anai Tovar. High honors. Angelica Vega. High honors. Julissa Vidales. Yesenia Villalobos. High honors. Kira Weller, high honors. Maria del Carmen Yanez, high honors.
So please join together in turning your tassel from right to left.
I believe I am a leader and I can make a difference in my community.